Well, how does it feel to become a member of the Hat Trick Club?
It feels pretty surreal, to be honest. I mean, the whole thing happened so quickly. And to get a hat trick, you know, my first one ever in my career, it feels pretty special to have done it.
Did you have to buy the boys a beer?
Yeah, I had to buy a few of the boys a beer, but luckily my family's over from New Zealand. So I went out and had a celebratory dinner with them, and you know, they were all pretty pleased that you know I got the hat trick, and they were pretty stoked as well.
And you did it specially for them, of course.
Yeah, of course I did, but it made it even more special that they had come all the way over here and they were able to witness it. So I had a few words with them after I got it at lunchtime, and they were pretty happy for me.
Well, talk us through it, the first wicket.
Well, the first wicket was round the wicket to Matt Pardo. Kind of straightened up on him, and I guess he edged it to the keeper, but a bit more bounce. The second one was to Moen Alley, who kind of played it late and chopped onto his stumps. And the third one, the most important one, was a bit of a ball, really. Seemed away, and Kavasia managed to nick it to the keeper.
So you had to buy the keeper a beer as well?
Yeah, you had to buy the keeper a beer because he took 4 on the match as well. So he had a great game as well.
What was going through your mind as you came up for that third wicket?
Well, before I got the wicket, Hamish Marshall came up to me and said, you don't have to go chasing the hat trick, you know, just bowl the ball like any other ball and you could get it. So after the wicket, I ran up to him and said, you know, well done, mate, cheers for the advice. He was stoked as well.
What did you actually try and do with that third ball?
The third ball, well, you know, I just tried to bowl a normal ball, really. Try to hit top of off, get a bit of movement away from the batsman, and just try to lure him into a false shot.
So what does that do for your confidence?
Well, it boosts it tremendously because, you know, the previous game I didn't take a wicket, so to get one was a bonus, but to get three and then five in the match five in the innings was an absolute bonus, really. And obviously it means that I'm doing the right sort of stuff at the moment. And hopefully, you know, I can kind of carry this sort of, you know, this joy, I guess, through the end of the season, take some more wickets.
Because you did so well yesterday, I can mention this. It's a slight contrast to a certain day last year.
Yeah, it was. Obviously, you're talking about the Sussex game, and Scott Skyris managed to hit me for 38 runs. That sort of, I guess, failure is key, really, because it keeps motivating you. I can easily look back on the videos all over the internet and watch that over. I use that over to motivate me sometimes. Again, you know, it's something to laugh about and something to talk about with the supporters at the ground.